So my dear students, welcome to my channel Biological Science. Okay, in this video we are going to learning about transgenic plants. Under transgenic plants, there are two important plants which are mentioned in our syllabus. One is golden rice and another one is BT cotton. In this lecture, we can look at on the golden rice. Before going to discuss about golden rice, we should know about what is meant by transgenic plants. Okay, first you have to know what is meant by transgenes. Transgenes are nothing but those are the foreign genes or the desired genes. If your organism which is going to carry that foreign genes or the desired genes, that organism is called as genetically modified organisms. For example, if your plant is going to carry that foreign gene or the desired gene, means that plant is called as a genetically modified plants. For example, if your animal is going to carry that foreign genes, means that animal is called as genetically modified animal. Okay, let us look at the clear definitions for transgenic plants. What are transgenic plants? Transgenic plants are called as those are the genetically engineered plants carrying gene or genes of another species in their genome. Okay, in their genome is nothing but a complete set of an organism which is going to carry the gene. Okay, it is called as a transgenic plants. Next we can look at on the golden rice. Golden rice and the process or the mechanisms of golden rice we can see, and another one is flowchart for golden rice we can see. Okay, it is mainly important application in agriculture. Okay, how this rice is said to be produced, means this golden rice is said to be produced by using genetically engineered method in biotechnology. Okay, as I told, what is meant by golden rice? Golden rice are nothing but those are the transgenic plants. Okay, golden rice are nothing but those are the transgenic plants. It is a genetically modified rice. Golden rice is nothing but it is a genetically modified rice made through genetic engineering method. By using genetic engineering method, the rice is said to be manufactured or produced in the laboratory techniques. Okay. It is a genetically modified rice, as I told. Okay, here the three genes are very important, essential for the production of golden rice. That two genes are said to be isolated from two different organisms. One is daffodil plant and another one is Erwinia bacteria. We can see that flowchart. After completion of this process, we can look at that flowchart. What exactly the golden rice? Golden rice is nothing but it is a transgenic rice which good qualities of beta carotene, which contains a good qualities of beta carotene, a precursor of vitamin A. Here the rice which is going to carry the vitamin A and it contains good qualities of beta carotene. What is the aim of production of this golden rice? Means the primary aim of this production of golden rice means to overcome from the problem. To overcome from the problem, that is VAD, vitamin A deficiency problem, that is called as nutritional disorder, in which year the golden rice is produced, discovered, means in the year 1919. Two scientists have been worked together. Before the discovery of golden rice, what is going to happen? Means before in the year 1919, okay, the WHO have been stated that every year 1 million people, million in the sense 10 lakhs, 1 million people are said to be caused death due to deficiency of vitamin A. Okay, whatever the food they are going to taking, okay, because of malnutrition, they are said to be dying every year 1 million people. And 230 million people facing the risk of this vitamin A deficiency. Vitamin A deficiency. To overcome that, this golden rice have been manufactured. And if you see the rice, rice is the simple diet for every human being. It is a simple diet for every human being. Why? Because it contains calories. It contains like calories like 25 to 80% of calories for human diet, which contains calories.
But
before discovery of golden rice, the people are facing lot of problems. Whatever the food we are taking, whatever the white rice we are taking now, during milling process, whatever the hull region which is covered by that food grain is said to be completely eliminated. Okay, that eliminated hull which contains some beta carotene, that is said to be eliminated. Due to that, the food which does not contain any vitamin A, so that the people are going to facing that malnutrition problem. Let us see the scientist name who discovered golden rice. There are two important scientists. One is Ingo Protricus, and another one scientist name is Peter Weir. These are the two important scientists who worked together in the year 1990. They discovered the golden rice. It's very important task. And if you see the mechanism or process for golden rice, just I will simply give you information about this, how this golden rice is produced. Means with the help of three genes, okay, with the help of the three genes, they discovered a golden rice. Okay, with the help of three genes. How that genes are said to be isolated means that genes are isolated from two different organisms. One is daffodil plant, two genes from the daffodil plants, and one genes from the Erwinia bacteria. These three genes are playing a very important role for the production of golden rice. Just look at the process. Important roles of that genes, how beta carotene is formed at the end. Just look at this daffodil plant, which containing a gene called as PSY gene. Contains a gene called as a PSY gene. This is which is giving rise to, that is pitoin synthase. Pitoin synthase nothing but it is an enzyme which is produced by the PSY gene. Which is produced by the PSY gene, which gives rise to again geranyl diphosphate, shortly called as GGDP. Okay. From this GGDP, pitoin synthase enzyme is said to be produced. Here, how many genes are playing an important role? Means here, two genes are playing an important role from the one plant, that is daffodil plant. Daffodil plant is nothing but it is a flowering plant, which contains some genes. That genes have the capability for the production of this golden rice. And another one plant, that is another one bacteria organism, that is Erwinia bacteria. Here another one gene is said to be isolated from this bacteria, that is carotene desaturase. Okay, carotene desaturase, nothing but it is an enzyme. Carotene desaturase gene, shortly called as CTRL, from Erwinia bacteria. Okay, from this pitoin is said to be produced. That pitoin is said to be converting into lycopene. Pitoin is said to be converting into lycopene, shortly called as LYC gene, which is finally at the end, which is going to give a beta carotene, which contains a that is a precursor of vitamin A. Finally, we got a product, that is beta carotene, because of this important genes. If we see the flowchart, we'll get clear cut. Okay, as I told already, from the daffodil plants, how many genes are said to be isolated? Means two genes are said to be isolated from the daffodil. And daffodil plant is nothing but it is a flowering plant. And one gene from the Evinia bacteria. First step in laboratory technique. Okay, three genes are said to be isolated from these two different organisms. This is the first step, selection isolation. And next step is whatever the genes are said to be isolated, now that is said to be carried out by genetic engineering method, that is by using a vector or plasmid. Vector or plasmid we are going to call. Vector, as I told already, vector is nothing but it is a gene carrier. What is the importance of these plasmids? Means these plasmids, nothing but it is a genetic tool which is going to carry these genes. These genes are said to be carried. Exactly at the reason, ORI reason, origin of replication. Exactly at that reason, these genes are said to be inserted. Once insertion is going to take place in plasmid means, then these plasmids are called as rDNA, recombinant DNA. It becomes a recombinant DNA. These plasmids are entering into the bacteria. Now these plasmids, which is going to carry that foreign gene, now these genes are said to be manipulated in huge quantities. If they have to manipulate it, means they should be carried in certain bacteria in biotechnology, that is agrobacterium. With the help of agrobacterium, where these plasmids are said to be isolated. Okay, where we will get clones of genes in the agrobacterium, these plasmids are said to be inserted. Here manipulation of genes or manipulation of clones of genes are going to take place. These agrobacterium are said to be maintained in nutrient culture. In nutrient culture, they are said to be maintained. From that nutrient culture,
start,
these plasmids are going to carry these genes, isolated genes. Now these plasmids are going to become rDNA. RDNA plasmids are said to be transformed into the agrobacterium. Why you are choosing agrobacterium is this bacterium have the capacity where the genes are said to be manipulated in huge quantities. This bacteria are said to be cultured in the media where we get clones of genes. Where we get the clones of genes. Whatever the bacteria are said to be added, again these bacteria are said to be added into a petri dish where contains of rice embryos. Where rice embryos is said to be present in the petri dish, in that these bacteria are said to be added. Okay, finally we will get the golden rice. Because of this transgene only, we are going to get the what is called golden rice. If you see this seed, which contains colorism, kernel, raisins. This is the rice which contains pro-vitamin A. Which contains pro-vitamin A. Finally, if you see the product, with the help of that seed, we are going to growing a plant. That plant is going to producing golden rice. We have the transgenic plant which is going to produce the golden rice. Okay, by understanding this topic, we come to know which is the main important role is going to play. This the important role here is going to play, that is transgenes. Hence the name itself called as transgenic plants. Okay, this is about transgenic plants under golden rice. In next video we can